Hello, once again, welcome to this presentation. My name is Philippe Adu. I'm one of the methodology experts, and today we're going to have a discussion concerning granular theory. So, introduction. So, granular theory is a systematic process. It's a step-by-step process, but it's also a repetitive process because you go back and forth looking at your data, reducing the data into codes, and sometimes have to go back to the data and see whether the codes reflect the data that you coded, right, or the segment of the data that you coded. So it's the back and forth. You go back, you develop it, go back again. Sometimes you have to go to the participant and interview them again to get more information to address your the questions that you have concerning the data that you originally collected. And this data collection process is very different because you are not technically collecting data. When you use the term collecting, sometimes it's a little bit of passive, right? You are going there, asking participant questions, and then they give you the information, you analyze and address your research question. Granular theory is very different. You are mining. This means that you are actively going and collecting or taking information or gathering information, actively gathering information that will help you to develop a theory or understand the phenomenon that you are focusing on. So, and this process is driven by your research problem or your research question, and also driven by the gaps that you identify in the initial stage. So when you first collect your data, you analyze, there might be gaps. There might be unanswered questions that you want to explore further. And you go back again and interview participant or analyze document or do observation, right? So granular theory is very active or intensive data collection process. And at the end of the day, you develop a theory to explain or understand a phenomenon, right? So that's all about the granular theory. It's a systematic process. It's back and forth, repetitive a little bit. You actively collect your data, and then you analyze the data, and then you develop a theory to explain a phenomenon or understand issue that you are focusing on. So this summary concerning analysis. So the process, so you start by examining your past, your background, your pre-knowledge about the issue, and trying to bracket them, put in a bracket, you know, trying to put them aside because you don't want the background information to adversely affect the analysis. And it's not going to be perfect, right? But the most important is that you are aware of your background and as you are analyzing so that it will not unduly affect the analysis, right? And you start with the initial coding and you get your basic codes, right? And then you do the focus code where you identify some important codes and try to put them into categories. And then you go to theoretical coding where you bring them together to explain the phenomena that you are focusing on.